is the comparison of free radicals, stability of free radicals, tertiary, secondary, primary, methyl, right? This one is the most stable. Can you explain the reason for that?
Because it has the lowest energy.
Yeah, this alkyl group have I plus inductive effect, right? That means these groups, this group pushes the electron cloud towards this direction, right? That means this group can stabilize this radical, similar to carbocation, right? So the most stable, that one is the least stable. Now we are going to talk about reaction between alkanes and these radicals. Alkanes are normally unreactive materials, right? Hydrocarbons, saturated compounds, right? For example, this. Normally, alkanes are unreactive. But radicals are very reactive, right? So radical can interact with alkane, then we can get products. For example, alkane, halogen, if you use energy, heat or light, we can generate radicals. Using this halogen, we can get products. For example, methane and chlorine. This chlorine can create radicals. Homolytic cleavage. This radical is very reactive. This reactive radical can interact with these hydrogens. We can get monochloro, dichloro, trichloro, tetrachloro products. Same thing for bromine. Actually, this chlorine radical is relatively unselective. That means chlorine can interact with primary or secondary or tertiary hydrogen. Take this example. This one is isobutane. This isobutane has two types of hydrogen, right? Primary hydrogen and what's the other one? Tertiary hydrogen. So we can create tertiary radical and primary radical, right? So this one is the most stable. That means if you draw the reaction coordinate, so tertiary has less activation energy, primary has a little bit higher activation energy, right? So according to this observation, major product is the primary product. This has less activation energy, right? Normally we expect this one as the major product, right? The reason is chlorine is very reactive, chlorine is unselective. Because chlorine has, if you compare chlorine and bromine, chlorine is electronegative. Chlorine is very reactive. Chlorine does not discriminate the position of the hydrogen atom. It can interact with this or this, but if you compare this radical and this radical, which one has the least steric hindrance? This one, right? That is the major product.
Least what you said?
Steric hindrance.
So it's based on
steric.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
Yep. Chlorine can interact with this and this. But if you compare these two, this has, yeah,
Is that the main reason why it's unselective? Is because of steric hindrance?
Reactivity. Because chlorine is very reactive. So chlorine can interact with any radical.
Okay.
So it doesn't care about the activation energy. But if you compare the steric hindrance, this one has less steric hindrance. Sorry, this one. This one has less steric hindrance. That's why this is the major problem.
Okay.
Is that clear?
Is that the same for bromine as well?
No. If you compare chlorine and bromine, bromine is less reactive. That means it doesn't have much energy. So that means bromine always try to find most stable one. If you use bromine, this is the major product. Because chlorine is more reactive, less selective. Bromine, more selective, less reactive. Bromine is generally less reactive, more selective. Chlorine has opposite problem. Next, we are going to talk about the mechanism. Reaction between halogen radical and alkanes. There are three main steps. Chain initiation, chain propagation, and chain termination. There are three main steps. First step of radical mechanism, generation of radical. AA means like a Cl2, something. It's a common name. H nu, energy. H nu. Or you can use heat. You can generate radical. Next step, chain propagation. Radical interact with this new molecule like CD. This is a single bond. Generate acene, another new molecule, and new radical. It's a chain propagation. For chain termination, always you have to combine two radicals. For example, this system has A and D, right? A dot plus D dot AD. It's the chain termination. Chain initiation, you have to create radical. Chain propagation, radical react with neutral molecules. Chain termination, you have to combine two radicals. These are the three main steps. Yeah.
What is the C stand for?
CDA, like I can say carbon monoxide. Like two atoms. These are arbitrary labels. Right? For example, this what is this A? We don't know.
Yeah, it's the chlorine dissociates and then
okay.
It's the radical.
So these are arbitrary molecule, A2, generate radical. This radical react with another arbitrary molecule. This represents a bond. We can get new product and a radical. Again, this radical, and this radical can combine to get this one, right? Next we are going to talk about actual reaction. Actually, this is a summary of the mechanism. Okay, let's go to the real reaction. Halogen, energy, we can create radical. This arrow is very important. This is a single half arrow. This is a half arrow, right? Normally, we use this one, right? What does this mean? You move two electrons, but in this case, one electron. You have to use half create radical. This is a chain initiation. Now, this one is unreactive, this one is very reactive, right? So now, this can propagate. Chlorine can break this bond, make HCl and a new radical. This new radical, this one is very reactive. This, like with another chlorine molecule, you can get a neutral product. Another new chlorine radical. Now, next, this chlorine radical can react with this one. We can get another radical. Chlorine radical, this one, CH2Cl radical. Now, this one is reactive, right? This can interact with chlorine again.
When does the reaction?
We are going there now. Okay. Because CH4 has four hydrogens, right? So we have to break four CH bond, we have to add four chlorines. Until we get that, we have to go step by step.
So it keeps going until it's done.
Yeah.
All right.
Is the halogen alkane and like IIA still neutral? Is that one neutral? No.
This one?
No.
This one?
Yeah, no.
This one? Which one?
The one in the middle of
this
two.
This one?
Yeah.
It's a chlorine. This doesn't have any radical, right? This unreactive. This doesn't have any radical. This unreactive. But this one has a radical. This very reactive. Now, again, this chlorine interact with this. This expanded structure. This chlorine can abstract this hydrogen. Again, you can create another radical. This radical can interact with neutral chlorine. We are repeating the same step, but only difference is the radical structure. Finally, we can get CCl4. Right?
After chain initiation,
yeah.
We have two very reactive.
This one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why that thing does not react to the one of them react to methane. What about why do they have to break that bond? Why do they have to break the CCl bond again?
No. Yeah, I know. There's a possibility, yeah. But we have explained the mechanism. Your system has millions of trillions of chlorine, same amount of methane, right? Because finally we are going to show how to make CCl4. This is a stepwise mechanism. I know your argument. Another second chlorine can react with another CH, right?
Mm-hmm.
Using that way also we can make. Like, for example, the second radical can react with this one, right? This CH2Cl radical, right? Then this radical doesn't have any chlorine radical. So this has to create another chlorine radical. Right. Yeah, because both radicals, chlorine radicals, react with this molecule first, right?
Oh.
But this is a stepwise mechanism.
So that second radical just found another chlorine?
Yeah.
You're saying?
Yeah. Okay, this is the final product, carbon tetrachloride. All these steps are chain propagation. These are chain termination because this radical and this radical, or this, you can combine any two radicals to make a neutral compound. These are unreactive, right? If system has radical, we can expect further reaction. So chlorine radical, methyl radical, methyl radical, methyl radical, chlorine this one, we can get neutral product. These are chain termination steps. Questions about this methane chlorination? Yeah.
So if those are those part of the product or no? So this is the chain termination?
No, these are products of this chain termination step. These are the products, these are the reactants.
So like if you do the reaction, you're gonna have all four of those and the other one?
These are possible chain termination products.
Plus the other one, right? The CCl4
is the main product of the reaction. This is the main product. But how do you get this product? We have to use methane chlorination under peroxide condition. This is the mechanism for that one. So chain initiation, you can create radicals, then propagation, 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 we can get this product. At the end, there are a lot of radicals in the system. Those radicals are very reactive. Those radicals can combine, make these products. But this is the major product. Carbon tetrachloride is the major product, that's the target product of the reaction. These things are so byproduct of the reaction.
Okay.
So I can ask this question. What are the possible chain termination product of this reaction? Methane chlorination. These are possible products, right? What is the major product of methane chlorination? Carbon tetrachloride.
What is the what?
Okay. What is the major product of methane chlorination? CCl4.
So to get the other products, you can stop it at
various points. Yes, we are going to discuss that next. Okay. If you use limited amount of chlorine, we can get mainly monochloro product because that one is limiting, this one is excess, right? If you use excess amount of chlorine, we can get CCl4 because system has enough chlorine to react with hydrogens in CH4. And another example, chlorine can react with primary or secondary or tertiary hydrogens, and we can expect different products. retain chlorination. We have to do the same mechanism, but more propagation steps. The reason is this has six CH bonds, right? Six CH bonds. What is the first step?
Dissociation.
Generation of radical, right? Common. Chain propagation, we have six CH bonds. So we can create a lot of propagation steps. If you use excess chlorine, this is your final product, right? Ethane chlorination. Propane chlorination. All these are chlorine if you use excess chlorine, right? Please try to write this mechanism, then you can understand. If you read, when you read, this one is very simple, but if you start to write, it is a little bit complex, right? Then chain termination, again, you can combine two radicals. How do you identify a chain termination step?
It produces a neutral molecule.
And both reactants are
radicals.
Questions about this methane chlorination and ethane chlorination mechanism?
So what would be the neutral molecule for the first?
This one? Mm-hmm. This doesn't have any radical, right?
That's our product energy.
This one is neutral, but these two are very reactive radical, right? So, that's the way you can identify a chain termination step product. So neutral reactants are radicals. As we discussed before, bromine is more selective. That means if you use alkane and bromine under this condition, major product is a tertiary product. So that reaction, this is a mechanism, right? Radical can abstract hydrogen. You can expect two types of radical, but this one is the most stable radical. That means this is the major product. For the comparison, first one, bromination, tertiary product is the major product, right? Because bromine is selective, less reactive. Chlorine, more reactive, less selective. So this one is the major product, right? Questions about this comparison? Next, we are going to talk about stereochemistry. If you will like that, right? Geometry. Okay. What is the geometry of this carbon? Trigonal. Sorry? Geometry? Tetrahedral. What is the bond angle? what is the hybridization of this carbon? There are four sigma bonds, right? 3 plus 1, 4, right? SP3. Yeah.
Is it 109.5?
109 is reasonable.
No, I'm just like asking to make sure it's the same thing that I'm thinking of.
Yeah. It depends on the repulsion of these groups, right? In some, as you can see, 109, 109.5. Now, if you break one bond homolytically, you can get this trigonal planar structure, right?
From the structure?
In the starting material, tetrahedral, if you break this bond, this p orbital has one electron because you break this one homolytically. That means this carbon has one electron. That electron stays on this p orbital. This p orbital is perpendicular to this plane, right? These three bonds are on the plane, this plane, right? This plane, p orbital stays like this, right? This geometry is a trigonal planar. Now hybridization is sp2 because this has only three sigma bonds. 1, 2, 3, 2 plus 1 equals 3, right? Now, halogen can interact from this side or that side, right? That means you can expect two products. One is R, one is S. If these groups are different, because we need a chiral center to get R and S, right? Okay, take this example. Pentane chlorination, monochlorination. So, if you create a primary radical, again, this one is this, right? This center. This has p orbital like this. Then chlorine can interact from this side or that side. But we cannot get chiral product because these two groups are similar, right? This molecule is achiral. This center has two similar groups. That means this is not a chiral center, right? If it is a chiral center, this center should have four different groups, right? But this has three different groups. So achiral molecule, if this is the product. Questions about this? If you create this radical, there are three possibilities, right? We are going to talk about all these possibilities. Again, this center is trigonal planar. Chlorine can interact from this side or that side. Now, one, two, three, four different groups, right? That means this is a chiral center. That means we can expect two products. Chlorine can interact from this side or this side, right? 50% R, 50% S. That's why this gives a racemic mixture. If you create a radical here, again, trigonal planar. chlorine can interact from this side or that side, but these two groups are similar. That means product doesn't have a chiral center, right? A chiral. Then I can ask this multiple choice question. How many possible products in this reaction?
Four,
yeah. One, two, three, four. Right. Questions about this. So you can expect these kind of questions in your test. Even ACS exam, these kind of questions. For example, how the possible product, I think 75% say three. They don't think about the RNS of that. Okay, this is pentane. This is the intermediate, this trigonal planar. Chlorine radical can interact from this side or that side, we can get two products, right? Mm-hmm. So this one is S, that one is R. So how do you determine R and S? If you can, imagine this structure, so you can hold from this hydrogen, then you have to assign the priority, then this way or that way, RO is right, one of these. But if you can convert this one to Fischer projection, you can easily get the 100% correct answer. How do you convert this one? Please follow these steps, okay? You really need this. This one is met a prop, I can write PR, okay? Normally when we draw Fischer projection, we draw two lines on the plane, right? Mm-hmm. But actual situation, these two ones, the vertical ones, project that direction. That direction, yeah. Okay. These two solid lines represent this. These two lines.
Doesn't matter which.
Doesn't matter. These two are on the plane, right? These two ones are on the plane. These two goes with this. That means CH3CN. Please follow these rules, okay? If you miss one. Now, this CH goes that direction, this CL goes that direction. This H and PR move like this, right? This one is H, this one is PR. Project this direction. That means this one is H, this one is PR. Any questions about this step?
I thought you just told me those two were in the plane.
What?
You said CH and CL are in the plane, in the same plane.
CH?
Three.
Okay. CL, CH3, right?
Right.
So now, like this, right?
Okay.
Then these two project this direction.
Okay.
Right? The actual situation like this. Right. Now, this one is number one, right? This one is number four.
Is four always going on the right hand side?
PR, yes. The PR, this direction.
No, whatever your fourth group is.
Huh?
Whatever your fourth group is. The number four group is that. It's always going to go on the right side.
According to this structure, it's on the right hand side. Okay, now this one is number one, no doubt, right? Chlorine. This one is number four, no doubt, right? Okay, this is a starting point. When you go this direction, first you meet carbon, right?
Mm-hmm.
You cannot differentiate these two.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have to go to the next round. When you go to the next round, this carbon has three hydrogens. Three. This carbon has two hydrogens and one carbon. That means 12, 13, 14. This one is three. So that means this one is two, this one is three. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Is that clear?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, you have to swap these group twice. Same time, you have to move the smallest group to the bottom. Swap twice. Move this small, whatever, the smallest group to the bottom. Hydrogen, four, one, two, three, right? Is that clear? Okay. First, I swap these two groups. Four is here, one is here now, right? Initially four is here, now four is here. So one time. Again, I'm going to swap these two. Two is here, three is here, right? Is that clear? Actually, different people follow different rules, right? This one is very simple. Yeah, when you go to feature projection, this is the actual situation in the feature projection. So these two go that direction, these two this direction, right? Now, then anti-clockwise, right? Okay, same way you can do this one, you will get R, right? So same connectivity, R and S, these two are called enantiomers, right? That means non-superimposable mirror images, right? Questions about this? This one is very important. These two bond project that direction, these two bond project this direction. So twice, same time you have to move the lowest one to the bottom. That's it. You can try that one, you can get R. Okay, this is another example. This is your starting material. This one is S, right? This, so this one is one. This one is. We don't need Fischer projection, like you can hold this molecule using this hydrogen like this. Now you can see 1, 2, 3, right? If you go to that room, then you get this molecule, then you can see 1, 2, 3, right? 1, 2, 3. S, right? This one is S. Then you can create radical here. Chlorine can interact from this side or that side. We can get two products. This is 2S3S, this one is 2S3R. These two are diastereomers. Because these two are not mirror images, but these two have the same connectivity. Right? There is a difference between diastereomers and enantiomers, right? Enantiomers, same connectivity, mirror images, non-superimposable. Diastereomers, same connectivity, those two are not mirror images, right?
Can you draw the Fisher projection model for the one you have on the board?
This one?
You say.
This one is propyl, right? These two bonds, PR and CH3, goes that direction. When you move these two towards that direction, these two project this direction, right? Now this one you have to stop twice. At the same time you have to move this one to the bottom. One, two. About primary, secondary, tertiary radicals, right? Next, we are going to talk about allylic or allelic radical. How do you identify allylic position? SP3 carbon next to the double bond. This position is called allylic. This radical, for example, this has three hydrogens, right? There are three hydrogens. So if you break this bond homolytically, you can create a radical here, right? This radical is called allylic radical. Allylic radical is very stable. The reason is this can create resonance structures. This radical, right? Allylic radical is a stable radical. Okay. This one example, allylic. This cyclohexene, there are two allylic positions right here. These are products of this fluorine or bromine. You know how to identify allylic position, right? SP3 carbon next to the double bond. Carbon-carbon double bond. Here, one allylic position. Here, there are two allylic positions. Here we have one comparison. Propene, halogen, high temperature, that means radical condition. We can get allylic product, right, as the major product. You can expect this also, but this is not that stable. But allylic product is more stable. That's the major product. If you use low temperature, same reactants, we can get this product. We discussed this in chapter 8. This addition reaction, right? High temperature, substitution reaction. Low temperature, addition reaction. Right? mechanism for that? Chain initiation, radical generation. Then this radical can abstract this hydrogen or this hydrogen, but this is the most stable, right? This is the major product. Then this radical can abstract chlorine, you can get the allylic chlorine. Halogenation reactions. Oh, we can start this on Wednesday.